All the facts, but I slowly destroy your innocence for 60 seconds. They eat nothing but eucalyptus, but if you took it off the tree and put it on a plate in front of them, they would stare at it and starve to death because koalas are not good at koaling. The only way they can eat this is by gaining a special gut bacteria, which they get by eating their mother's backdoor fudge. Every koala has done this. Koalas can be vicious psychopaths. Some people broke into a zoo to steal a koala and left with a crocodile because that was easier than handling a pissed off Bundy bear. Koalas have fingerprints identical to humans, meaning they can contaminate crime scenes, and with 7 billion people on Earth, at least one is in jail for something a koala did. They don't hug people, they're using your body to cool off because this genius thinks you're a tree. Most koalas have incontinence, meaning they pee themselves uncontrollably. Which leads right into the next fact, because as you probably already know, 90% of koalas are infected with chlamydia. But you probably didn't know that 10% contain a strain that can be passed on to humans. Or should I say, pissed on to humans. Males don't recognize the sign that a female is in heat, so he'll just rape first and ask questions never in a process that can knock the female out the tree. Because the sound of this attracts more sexually frustrated males, the female gets run through like a track meet. She gets choo-chooed against her will. Hunting pandas for 60 seconds straight. They're bad at literally everything. They're bad at sex. Zookeepers had to play videos from PandaHub just to give these bears an idea of how the parts work. They're bad at making more of themselves because female pandas can only get pregnant 2 days a year. They're bad at staying alive. Baby pandas only have a 40% chance of living to their next birthday, and most of the time they die in the first week, and sometimes the mother sits on them and accidentally takes them out. They're bad at being parents because if a female has twins, she'll take Zach and abandon Cody. They're bad at pandaing because even though they're literally designed to eat meat, they eat nothing but bamboo, and since they get so little energy out of it, they have to eat 40 pounds of it a day. Their only real talent is being cute, and if they weren't, we wouldn't be spending millions of dollars protecting an animal that nature clearly doesn't have a plan for. And they're not even great at the whole cute thing either. Pandas may be bad at bearing, but they're still bears. One man was trying to teach a panda how to survive in the wild, and to encourage him, he dressed up in a panda suit. The ungrateful fur Oreo proceeded to bite off half his hand. Also, male pandas will delete any babies they see, even if they end up being his. The only W's pandas take are in Disney movies. There is no bigger disappointment than a bear that identifies as an overweight or quality gerbil. They're baby-faced abominations that just get clapped by life. Zebra fact, but you're going to hate them by the end of this video. Zebras are actually black with white stripes, and they help keep disease-causing flies from landing on them. Hey, real quick, Google what animal causes the most zookeeper injuries and get back to me. Yeah. Zebras put more people on workers' comp than any other animal because they're not horses, they're angry Afro donkeys. The whole reason we never tried riding them is because they would literally kick the life points out of any Doolittle that tried. Zebras are strong enough to do this to lions. In Madagascar, since Alex had no hunting experience, Marty would have Mufasa'd him if he tried anything. A zebra choosing violence can either shatter a lion's jaw or crack its skull in half depending on where it lands the kick. When a male zebra sees a pregnant female, he'll do things to her that would make him roommates with Cosby and Epstein. Well, I guess just Cosby now. He'll literally violate her until he either forces her to miscarry or her body reabsorbs the fetus. And that's if she's pregnant. Now, if she already has a baby, the striped abortion clinic with legs will personally erase it, and his favorite method is by drowning it. And he'll do it while the mother desperately tries to save her child. So the next time you see this Oreo horse getting clapped by a lion, just know this homicidal barcode probably had it coming. Facts, but they get a lot less cute the longer we go. First, wet sloth. That's the end of the sentence. They can swim 3 times faster than they can walk, and they can hold their breath longer than dolphins, which sounds cool. But if you ever saw something like this in person, you wouldn't be okay mentally for a long time. Every time you eat an avocado, you're probably eating the descendants of disease a giant ground sloth ate and pooped out. They're one of the few animals big enough to swallow the fruit and spread the seed, so you can thank his prehistoric anus for guacamole. They only poop once a week, and when they do, they avoid about a third of their body weight, which would be like the average man dropping a 60-pound deuce. Since this takes so long, most sloths get their life subscription canceled on the toilet like Elvis. They basically play Russian roulette every time they leave the tree to drop the kids off. And speaking of dropping kids, they give birth in the trees, and sometimes the babies fall straight to the ground. Sometimes the mother will decide it's not worth the effort and will leave the baby to die. Just call it a baby shower. Also, sloths don't mistake their own arms for branches and then fall to their death. That's a myth. What isn't a myth is that sloth grip is so strong they can remain hanging from a tree even while they're dead. If you see an upside-down sloth in a tree, there's no guarantee he's alive. Sloths have been known to break into human toilets and eat whatever forbidden fudge they can find. Because you don't have to be Odell to play for the Browns. You're gonna regret that comment, quokka facts, but they somehow get more and more disturbing. They live on Rat's Nest Island, named after Rat's Nest, because the first people to see them thought they were rats on steroids. But they're marsupials related to kangaroos and koalas. They're cute, but they have plant-crushing teeth, and they won't hesitate to use these little hole punchers on you if you get too close. People forget that these are wild animals and not plush toys, and they get bit as a result. That kid got checked right in the forehead. Mother quokkas have insurance policies on their children because she has an egg called a blastocyte that'll start developing if her first kid gets third-party aborted. That would be like your own mother having a replacement clone ready in case you get put on a shirt. Because her child is replaceable, when chased by a predator, Mother of the Year will sacrifice her baby. She doesn't eat her own child to its death the way memes seem to think she does, but she does loosen the muscles on her pouch so her baby falls out. On purpose, by the way. But the really messed up reason this works is because the baby hisses and screams when it hits the ground, getting the predator's attention. So the mother gets away while her baby gets taken off the census. Since quokkas have huge cycles of births and deaths, if you go to Rat's Nest Island at the wrong time, you'll see more quokka skulls than your mental health will be able to handle. Stop telling me to ruin animals, I'ma keep doing it. Rat facts, but they slowly get more and more disturbing. Because giraffes are usually the tallest thing on a dry open savanna, it's not uncommon for them to get clapped by lightning, and when this happens, their heart basically beats itself to death. They have hooves the size of dinner plates, and they've been seen on record decapitating lions with one kick, which is why baby giraffes will hide under their mothers when predators attack. He may be safe from lions, but sometimes a mother friendly fires him with a kick that shatters his neck. Baby giraffes are just as likely to get accidentally killed by their mothers as they are lions. Males flirt by slamming their heads into the side of the female until she forcefully pees. They'll taste test her pee to see if she's ovulating to decide whether to apply pressure. 90% of giraffe sex is between two males, and nothing's wrong with that, you know, love who you love. But most of the time, it's an older giraffe asserting his authority on a younger, weaker male. This isn't an act of love, he's basically getting Shawshanked by a long-necked Sandusky. Giraffes are extremely vulnerable to parasites, and when one gets sick, he'll get abandoned by his herd who basically leaves him to die. Sounds harsh, but if you saw what a sick giraffe looks like, you'd understand. Which is why if Madagascar were real, Melman would have suffered a slow, painful, parasitic-induced death. You're not gonna believe how big these animals really are. This is how big people think snapping turtles get. This is how big they actually get. If my eyes have to be assaulted with this image, you better believe I'm gonna make it your problem too. Here's a friendly reminder that your little house cat is related to an 11-foot, 700-pound biracial Garfield. This cat can stand up and make eye contact with a basketball rim that most of the population can't jump high enough to touch. Don't let the baby bottle fool you, that man is a mood swing away from becoming a human scratching post. I feel like people forgot just how ridiculous blue whales are, so here's a reminder that this picture actually exists. Female blue whales are actually bigger than the males, and the biggest grow to 100 feet long. Meaning this blue whale is longer than a standard NBA court. This picture's actually wildly out of pocket the longer I look at it. I'm not even gonna sit here and demonize orangutans. They're intelligent and peaceful, and they rarely choose violence, but violence is on the table. Life is multiple choice, and if this ginger Bigfoot circles C, it's gonna be bad for her. Elephant seals are big. They can weigh 9,000 pounds, and I was gonna say this man has balls, but this isn't balls. This is a lack of brain function. He's one body slam away from becoming a chalk outline. This is actually one of my favorite series. It's called Animals That Are Way Bigger Than Your School Taught You. Yeah, that's a goddamn turtle. The leatherback can grow to 7 feet long and weigh 1,500 pounds. Because when it comes to turtles, you have the pets you can hold in your hand and you have refrigerators with flippers. Oh, and this is what their mouth looks like. The Andean condor is one of the biggest bastards with wings with a 10.5-foot wingspan. This guy has a 7'3" wingspan and his arms are longer than a Monday. Luckily, they only eat already dead animals, so they're perfectly harmless. But nobody ever told him that. Also, this dinosaur can live for 70 years. That is what a gorilla's hand looks like compared to a human's. And we should all take a moment to be grateful that gorillas rarely choose violence because those mitts could easily slapbox their soul into a factory reset. You probably forgot how much of a unit Appa really was. At 9 feet, 2,200 pounds, the American bison is literally the biggest threat to American idiots everywhere. Not only is it a truck with legs that can charge at 40 miles per hour, as you can see from this picture, actions have consequences. Meet Patrick, the largest wombat to ever wombat. This furry tank can cripple cars, and they use their thick to crush predators that get too close. Only in Australia could a plush toy take on a Honda and win. There are some animals that have no business being that big. There is no ethical reason for this picture to exist. Like, I know what this is, I just don't know why. The Japanese spider crab can have a leg length of 12 feet, can weigh 44 pounds, and can live for 100 years because even death procrastinates dealing with this thing. Next, we have the giant freshwater stingray, and I really appreciate giant being in its name, as if I could possibly think something like this is average. Now, I have personally forgiven stingrays from what they've taken away from me, but I'm not at peace with a 16-foot, 1,300-pound placemat with a tail. They're found in Southeast Asia, Borneo, and the dreams of the unwell. Not to be confused with the giant oceanic manta ray. At 23 feet, 6,000 pounds, the manta ray is 100% perfectly harmless. Except to your mental health. Cause every time this underwater UFO pulls up on somebody, a therapist goes up a tax bracket. Now we have the wolf eel. Why? At 8 feet long, it's proof that there's no rules in the ocean. If God wants Godzilla in the form of a tadpole, then damn it, that's just what's gonna happen. Also, they mate for life, so if you're still single, just know that this thing is somehow doing better than you. Blue whales are fundamentally disrespectful, but there's only one way for you to understand just what we're up against here. You know exactly what that is. Five animals that used to be way worse. At number 5, we have penguins. There used to be a species of mega penguin that was tall enough to look a 6-foot man in the eyes. In fact, the biggest one grew to 6'8 and weighed 250 pounds. A whole penguin built like LeBron, I promise you, you'd want no problems. Number 4 are orangutans because they're the closest living relative of Gigantopithecus. 10 foot 600 pound steroid Donkey Kong. They're probably vegetarian, so you wouldn't have to worry about them eating you. Doesn't mean they couldn't practice origami with your skeleton if you gave them a reason. Orangutans are cool, but a ginger Bigfoot is not it. Number 3 are rhinos for two reasons. Satanic unicorn nonsense right here. And this. Paraceratherium was a hornless rhino that grew to 30 feet, 44,000 pounds, and that's what you'd look like next to him. All of a sudden, this picture makes sense. It's just elephants evening the score after centuries of abuse. Speaking of elephants, I'll never understand how this acid trip left the giraffes. This is Platybelodon, and it looks like an elephant fucking platypus and a power tool, and this is what came out. Not to mention, this used to exist. Number 1 is a Sariema because they used to be terror birds. 10 feet, 300 pounds with a murder weapon for a nose, they would have been the biggest op to mankind. We would all be on shirts.